A hand lens is one of the most useful tools for a gardener. A good hand lens will allow you to identify problem pests and diseases, as well as beneficial organisms. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use your hand lens. And when you get comfortable using it, you're going to come to find your hand lens is indispensable. Is a small device used to magnify something that an entomologist or a horticulturalist might be looking at. Many species of insects can only be identified by viewing very small characteristics. So if you're trying to figure out what's eating a plant, a hand lens will help you discover that. And for botanical purposes, a hand lens works much better than a magnifying glass. The optic in a hand lens can be made from glass or plastic. Plastic may be cheaper and more lightweight, but it damages more easily, it's hard to clean without scratching, and it will not provide the optical clarity that a glass lens will provide. A hand lens comes in various magnifications. A 5x or less really isn't worth bothering with, while a 20x can be difficult to use because they give a narrower field of view and there's often greater distortion toward the edges. For nature study, a 10x magnification is ideal. A good source of light is important when using a hand lens. Bright sunlight is ideal, but another bright light source, such as from a ceiling light, is sufficient. Be sure and position yourself so the ambient light is pointing towards the specimen, not the hand lens. Some hand lenses have LED lighting in order to illuminate the object being viewed. These can be very useful in low light conditions, such as when you're using your hand lens indoors. It's a good idea to attach a lanyard to your hand lens. This will keep you hands-free and help prevent your hand lens from being dropped or lost. Hand lenses are not used in the same way as a traditional magnifying glass. Here's how to use one. First, determine which is your dominant eye. You can do this by forming an opening between your hands and focusing on an object in the distance. Gradually bring your hands closer until they touch your face, and then observe which eye it is that is looking through the opening. This is your dominant eye. Next, rotate the lens part out of the frame and loop your index finger through the frame or hold it in whatever manner you prefer. Bring the hand lens up to your dominant eye, having the hand holding the lens in contact with your cheek. The lens shouldn't touch the eye, but should be as close as possible. If you wear glasses, you can either remove them or you can keep them on and rest the lens very close or actually against the glasses. Try both ways and see which is most comfortable for you. Hold the specimen between the thumb and forefinger of your other hand and gradually bring it closer until it comes into sharp focus. With a 10x lens, this will occur when it is about 1 inch away. Try to maintain contact between the hand holding the lens against your cheek and between your right and left hand. This will give maximum control and allows you to keep the specimen and lens steady. If it's not practical or possible to bring the object up to you, you can move your entire head with the hand lens held in place towards the object until it comes into sharp focus. You may find it easier to shut the other eye, but with practice, you may find that you can use the lens without needing to do so. Keeping both eyes open reduces eye strain. Thank you for watching. We hope you have fun investigating your surroundings in detail with your hand lens. For more information about hand lenses, check the description box below.